Hey, Lenny, your life is no joke. This is the Vitamix One, and we're excited about it because, well, the hardest question for us to answer for the last decade of doing this was, it's just me, I live alone, what do I get? And so Vitamix, knowing this, their first try was the S series. Tiny footprint, can do everything. The problem was the performance wasn't very good. Their next shot was the E series, the E310. So full power, full size base, and a 48 ounce container kind of in between. And it did everything well, great. The problem was it was so loud that we had to ask for another demo unit to make sure that we didn't get a defective model, because we couldn't believe how loud it was. The third shot at a Vitamix for one person is this, the Vitamix One. It can't do everything, but what it can do, it does really well. You know, so I think Vitamix learned from their mistakes of their first two at-bats of trying to make a Vitamix for one person. It's got the small footprint, but it's not super loud. The blend quality is great for what it can do. And it's got the feature that's unique to Vitamix that makes it just to clean. The blade being fixed to the container. A couple drops of soap, warm water, run it, and it's clean. And the controls are really simple. It's just a dial. There are no switches, there are no programs, there's no extra on and off button. And admittedly, this is a little weird for us because for all these years, we've said, well, any Vitamix can do. They all can do all the things, but this one can't do all the things. And that's what makes it actually pretty cool. It almost makes it like less of a Vitamix per se, and more of just like a pro blender, a pro smoothie maker, a pro protein shake maker. Really like the best little blender that you can get. I mean, it's exciting. This thing rocks. When we make recommendations for people of which Vitamix to buy, we say take a minimalist approach. The Vitamix One, this really supports a minimalist lifestyle. So let's talk about what it can do. It does blender things really, really well. And the reason is because the blade, like all Vitamix blades, are laser cut. So they're not sharp. They're dull out of the box, and they use power and engineering to pulverize ingredients instead of slice them. You're gonna get results that are the same every time, from blend one to blend 1000. We made our green juice and it was really good. We had to have the recipe, which is okay if it's just you. We used kale, and the consistency was the same as when we make our green juice in a full-size Vitamix, like the A3500 that's in our kitchen.
How is it?
It's good, no chilies.
And then we made protein shakes. So standard protein shakes with frozen banana, protein powder, nuts, oats. And it was an excellent protein shake, like silky smooth, especially for using oats and powder. No banana chunks, awesome. And then we made a Vitamix staple, thick smoothie bowls. So we made our acai bowl recipe. We just did a video about this. I think that'll be over here. And this is mostly frozen ingredients. So we had to use the tamper to gently push the ingredients down into the blade, and it worked great. Which to me proves that it can do other frozen dessert type of things. So banana and ice cream, sorbets, really any sort of frozen dessert that you would make ice cream with a tamper, this thing, the Vitamix One, is gonna be able to handle. What we didn't make that it definitely can do very well. Sauces and dressings. Our Thai peanut sauce, our bright blue vinaigrette, Caesar dressing, ranch dressing, and small batches of that too. Baby food as well. It's a 32 ounce container, so it's the right size to make a batch of dressing and sauce for tonight. The Vitamix One can technically make salsa. They show a demonstration of that on the Vitamix website, but you're fairly limited in the texture. And we'll talk about that in a second. And as we alluded to before, it was super easy to clean. Warm water, a couple drops of soap, run it for a few seconds, and it's clean. No need to like get in there with a brush and take it apart. They stay together. So if you've never had a blender that's designed like that, I mean, that's like a whole new world of, there's just one less thing to deal with. Quick time out, guys. Hey, did you know that this is what we do for a living? Lenny Gale, Shawva Gale, life is no joke. We are the mom and pop Vitamix shop. This is what we do. It's our little family business. We've been doing it for about a decade. So if you use our links to make your purchases and you see our name at checkout, 06 No Yolk, we should get credit for your purchase, and that'll help us do what we do. So thank you so much for supporting our work, and back to the review. Okay, For everything that the Vitamix 1 can do, and can do well, there are a lot of things that it can't do, and you're not allowed to do. In the instructions, it says you cannot do dry grains, nut butters, or hot soups. And you also can't put it in the dishwasher. In fact, the warranty says your warranty is void if you try and do these things. Don't call us if you try to do what we told you not to do. I mean, they're so serious about this that they branded these little warnings on the container itself. It's not just there is a sticker that says not to do these things, but there's also like a engraved thing that says, here's what you can't do. And so these are the things that require long run times. You can't run the Vitamix 1 for more than 3 minutes and that have high impact. So if you're grinding dry grains, all these things have potential to trip up the machine, mess up the motor and break it. But in practice, does it matter? If you're following our lifestyle, or if one of your friends or family made one of our signature dishes for you in their Vitamix, and that's what sold you on getting a Vitamix, there's a chance that you might not be able to make that thing in the Vitamix 1. So soup, so our broccoli cheese soup, that's a start to finish soup made in the Vitamix, you can't do that in the 1. Our queso, that's nuts, seeds, spices, and a pepper, blended for 6 minutes until it's hot to get you. You can't do that in the Vitamix 1 unless you, well, soak all the nuts and then just sort of transfer everything to the stovetop, which you can. Nut butters. We make nut butters occasionally because we outsource nut butters for the most part. We do. They're better when we make them at home, and we wish we did more often. But what we do is make cookie balls, and that's sort of the same nuts and dates, really thick ingredients that you need the tamper to push down into the blade. Our blueberry cookie bites, our hula bites, our iron bites, you can't make those in the 1. Dry grains. If you're not making your own dry grains today, we say you don't need a dry grains container, and don't worry about that doing that in your Vitamix. In our lifestyle, we make cornmeal made out of popcorn to make our cornbread. So you wouldn't be able to do that in the 1, but you can't do hot drinks in the 1. Butter coffee or turmeric latte or golden milk. It's not dishwasher safe. I think this is a heat thing. It can't really handle the heat. All those things, you try and do all those things, it's gonna make your Vitamix 1 upset. And if you admit to Vitamix customer service that you tried those things, there's not a whole lot they can do for you. Technically, you can see this on the Vitamix website that it can make salsa. Here's the problem. It felt like the lowest speed wasn't as low as you could get with a full-size machine. So your salsa is gonna be pretty processed, but it can do it. One last thing, food prep. If you've been with us for a long time, we use our Vitamix to make a detox salad. It's a coarsely chopped salad. Technically, you could do that in this Vitamix, but it would take a really long time because the blade in the Vitamix 1 is like 2.5 inches versus in the full-size containers are now 4 inches. You could do it, but it would take a long time. All that said, all the things that the Vitamix 1 cannot do, it's still awesome for the right people. So let's talk about who the Vitamix 1 might be for. The Vitamix 1 might be for you if you're just getting into a healthy lifestyle. Look, 80% of the people that come to us and are like, all right, I'm ready to get a Vitamix, they come from a Nutribullet or a Ninja. And they say to us, my Nutribullet finally died. I'm ready to get a Vitamix. Because for most people that want to start making smoothies and protein shakes, their budget is between $100 and $200 at the most, not between $400 and $600. And so we say, get a Vitamix alternative, get a Nutribullet, and then come to us when you're ready. We're not going anywhere. But with the 1, that changes things a bit. If you only have $100, still go get a Nutribullet. But if you have $200 and are just getting into a healthy lifestyle, spend the extra 50 to get the Vitamix 1 because it's gonna outperform anything else at that range. You're gonna love it way more for way longer versus an alternative. You're gonna love it and you're gonna be excited about it, especially for the first few times. And then you're gonna be excited for the day that it dies and that you can get a Vitamix. The Vitamix 1 might be for you if you live alone. Tiny footprint. Right size container, great for smoothies, shakes, and smoothie bowls, and sauces. you can make a full-size Vitamix work if you're alone, especially if you get a 20-ounce cup as well, or you want to batch your smoothies and shakes. But now with the Vitamix One, this is a no-brainer. This is not only going to be our budget pick, this is also the pick for people that live alone. No question. Vitamix One might be for you if you are getting a graduation gift. So graduating from high school and moving into a dorm, or graduating from college and moving into your first apartment. A full-size Vitamix, even for someone who just graduated, is still just like a little bit too much of a gift. But now with this, at the price, at the size of it, it's like, it's just like, it's so perfect. And a wedding gift too. I mean, even if the newlyweds, the couple, they grow out of it in a few years, that's fine. Vitamix One might be for you if you are fortunate enough to have a lake home or a cottage or another home where you're like, oh, when I'm there, I miss having my Vitamix. And you don't need the full-size Vitamix to make the nut butters or hot soups. You just want something to make your protein shakes and your smoothies. The Vitamix One is the perfect thing for that. Perfect. Who might the Vitamix One not be for? If you're going all in on the lifestyle, it can't do everything. If you have a family, a large family, this isn't the best fit. If you want to get a machine that you can add on to someday, add a personal cup, add a food processor attachment, add an air disc container, the Vitamix One only works with the container that it comes with, the cute little 32-ounce container. Guys, I think this is gonna do so much good for Vitamix and for people that are interested in getting into a healthy lifestyle. So my hope is that you're looking at this and you're comparing it to a Ninja. You take away the fact that it's no comparison, and it's a great way to begin a healthy lifestyle. Guys, the Vitamix One rocks, and I'm excited for all the people that are gonna be able to get a Vitamix now. Guys, if you're still here, it means you're really interested in this machine and you're intrigued by us and what we do. I want you to know that the Vitamix One is awesome. There's gonna be a lot of places for you to get it. We would love if you bought it from us, but if you don't, that's okay. Please come into our world. Let us show you the promised land, give you a taste of this lifestyle, of the good life, because it really is good. Using this tool to eat a little better and feel a little better. So thank you so much for watching. Subscribe to our channel if you haven't already, and we'll see you in the next one. Bye, guys. Oh, hey, buddy.